May the word of my mouth and the meditations of our heart be acceptable to God in our Lord and our Redeemer. Please be seated. For those who do not know me, I am not Fred Hanna. I'm very happy to see many faces because of this wonderful servant who has passed on to the Lord. Today we are going to celebrate him and remember him. Today is All Souls, All Saints, and Patrons Day. But before I go, I want to also inform you that last week Saturday there was a vestry retreat. And we had a great conversation about the future of this great church, which priests like Fred Hanna has passed through and gone. We decided to continue serving God, and we decided that going forward in 2018, we must endeavor to do one unique benefit that all churches around us are doing. So for your assignment, for being here this morning, if you look at the back of your pews, there are pencils and there are small booklets. Everybody should take one now. Take a pencil and take a small book, a small leaflet sheet. Before you leave this service, we would like to hear what you want us to do with this church and what you wish to be done. And we are talking about not the general things. What is the one uniquely better thing that all saints can do for the community around us, for the parishioners here, for everyone who comes? What is the one uniquely thing that we can do? Our first lesson of Joshua is about our personal commitment to God. And when I talk about personal commitment, this is an area that nobody can make that commitment for you. You need to do it personally. And in the reading, the Bible says that they presented themselves before God. That means when we gather on Sunday mornings, you have not presented yourself to a denomination or to a priest, but you have come before God. And that's exactly why we are here this morning. And we come to church to say thank you to God for what you did for me last week and ask God to bless us the following week. This should be the mind of every Christian. Because when you come before God. And Joshua was reminding this great growing population about their past. And he says, long ago your ancestors, Terah and the sons of Nahor, lived beyond the Euphrates and served other gods. You might say today, sitting here, that I don't serve any other gods. But I want to tell you that your ancestors used to. And who are your ancestors? They were the Greeks and the Romans. I come from Africa. In Africa, we used to worship everything until Christianity came. So, we all used to worship the princes. But Joshua is reminding the people of Israel, as he is reminding us this morning, about our worship to God. And therefore we must worship the Holy God, but serve Him in sincerity and in faithfulness. This morning, I am encouraging all of us to heed to this great advice. Not only should we worship God, but we must do it in sincerity of our hearts. We must do it in faithfulness. And we must put away every other God. Oh, my brothers and sisters, There are so many other gods in our time. All sorts of things are taking our attention and our worship of the good Father that we sang about this morning. All sorts of manner, lifetime, culture, temperament are taking over. And therefore, we must put them away. But Joshua is just making an affirmation to them. But as for me and my household, we will serve that God. This morning, I want to remind you again, it is a personal commitment. No one can do it for you. And this is my prayer, that as you hear me this morning, you will say the same thing to yourself. As for you and your household, you worship the Lord. And the people answered. You have to answer for yourself. The priest cannot do that for you. The denomination cannot do that for you. You have to answer yourself. And they said, therefore, we also serve the Lord, for he is our God. And Joshua was trying to tell them about this God. He's a holy God. He's a jealous God. And he will not forgive our sins and transgressions if we don't confess them. And if we continue to remain in sin, he will not forgive us. And Joshua affirmed to them, if you are saying so, then you are witnesses to what you are saying. The Lord our God will serve and will obey him. You and I too must make our own confessions this morning and for the rest of our lives. This morning as we celebrate and remember the ever-charming, the Reverend Frederick J. Hammond. It is so profound that our text in Thessalonians is talking about the death. And the text is saying to us, we do not want you to be misinformed or uninformed, brothers and sisters, about those who are dying, so that we continue to grieve as we do not have any hope. This morning, the people who love Fredana, who are here this morning, the Bible is saying that we will see Fredana again. And therefore we should stop grieving, but celebrating as we are doing this morning. So, are the people in your lives that you have lost? So, are the many people that we have lost as a congregation this year? This afternoon at 2 o'clock, we will be in the cemetery to do another service there. And if you have a relative there, please come and be part of us. Because Jesus died and rose again, God will bring us who have believed in him. And therefore, encourage one another with these words. Encourage one another with these words. Our loved ones will see them again. Our loved ones will have passed on to glory, including Fred Hanna that we are celebrating. In my conclusion, we are looking at the gospel. And that gospel is for every individual in this congregation this morning. That gospel gives us personal responsibility. It gives us personal decision and choices for everyone who is alive and hearing me. I didn't choose these words. It's written in the Bible. And the Bible is saying that five of the bridesmaids were foolish. And five were wise. This morning you need to determine who you are. Are you foolish or you are wise? I'm not saying that. Please, don't bear me a grudge. The Bible is saying this. Who are you? Are you prepared in this life and also for eternal life? The word, the foolish took their lamps and they took no oil. But the wise took flasks of oil. Are you taking oil with your time? What is your oil? What appropriation are you doing in your time? Are you just living a lie that you are saying to yourself, oh, when we get there, we'll see what we do. When we get to the bridge, we'll cross it and we'll find a way. No. No. You better be wise now. Because it happened to them that when the time came and they needed to present themselves, they didn't have oil. And they were begging for oil. Don't beg for oil. Get your oil now. Live a life now that will not make you found wanting when the bridegroom comes. That is Jesus Christ our Lord. It will be too late. People say that nobody has gone there to come back. And I always tell people, be prepared just in case. Get an oil just in case. Because you might be a very good parishioner. You might be a very faithful contributor. You might be doing all the right things. But without your oil of life, which is the very life that you are living, the Lord will say to you, truly, I don't know you. So this morning you have a personal responsibility to give your life to Christ. You have a personal responsibility to oil your life, your Christian life. You have a personal responsibility to make that choice. Otherwise, it will be said to you and I that I don't know you. Therefore, keep awake. Keep awake. For you neither know the day nor the hour. Nobody knows. It will be my time tomorrow or this afternoon. Are you ready for that day? As we remember the ever charming, the most loved. Oh, he was so loved in this community. Even today, even this day when I go out of the station and I tell people that I'm from All Saints, they ask me, do you know Fred Hammond? I have believed him. He lived his life full of the oil that we are talking about this morning. And therefore, it's our personal responsibility also to do the same. Let us bow our hands and pray. Pray for yourself. Pray for yourself and prepare for that day. It doesn't matter what you've done, what you are doing. Just ask Jesus to come into your life and give you that oil that you need to prepare to wait for him. He's the only one who can give you that oil. Let us bring our personal prayers to an end. Let's turn up together as one family as we affirm our faith in the Nicene Creed. Let us all turn up together if we can. Let us stand together.